Hi, I'm Timia Presley. Thank you for joining me today. Yesterday, somebody asked me about intensifying the abdominal work, in particular in the lower abs. So let me tell you about it, and let me tell you two little tricks that really help with that, that are really effective with that. If you're looking to focus on working with the lower abdominals more, or you're looking for that typical thing that any Pilates marketing material promises to you, which is flat abs, the key is to focus on the breathing. The key is to make sure that you really add proper breathing technique to your Pilates routines. Use the typical lateral costal Pilates breath that finishes or incorporates widening and flattening of the tummy. What happens with the breath in Pilates? We inhale through the nose and let the rib cage expand three-dimensionally. We don't inhale into the lower tummy, we don't let the abdominals expand. And on the exhale breath, gently move the ribs down and in while widening, flattening the tummy, which means your transversus abdominis muscle engages. Transversus abdominis wraps around the front of the body, connects into the back, into the thoracolumbar fascia, and it's a little bit like an internal back brace that you can pull tight for stabilization of the lumbopelvic region, really, so that's really our goal. But if you're looking for that flat tummy appearance, this is the muscle that will do it for you. So really a really nice abdominal exercise is to lie down on your back and breathe this way, or stand up or sit up and breathe this way. Exhale, pulling the belly in, widening, flattening the tummy, also bringing the ribs down and in. If you move the ribs down and in too much, you will not be able to engage transversus abdominis. If you engage transversus abdominis too much, and by the way, transversus abdominis engagement goes hand in hand with pelvic floor engagement. They sort of fire together. The pelvic floor aids in firing transversus abdominis. So if you engage transversus abdominis too much, the rib cage will not be able to close. So by doing these two things together, really three things, if we consider the pelvic floor as well, you will be able to get that dynamic engagement that's just enough that will help you to be stable for performing different movements, but not be rigid. Okay, so intensifying abdominal work doesn't mean doing more sit-ups. It does not mean that we have to do some very special exercises. It just means that we have to do the exercises we already do differently, incorporating the Pilates breath, and through the Pilates breath, the engagement of the center. Thank you for watching. I hope that this information was helpful. I look forward to seeing you next time.